purses, frames, clothes, bags, coasters, and so on and so forth. Fabric weaving looks good on everything. There are different types of fabric weaving, but today we are going to go over the most simplest and basic of them all, which is basket weaving. So without further ado guys, let's go over the things that we need to get this DIY done. Some things we actually need and some things are just accessories to make the whole DIY process a lot easier. Our bias maker is not a need, but it is an accessory or a tool that will make your bias making process a lot easier. I'm going to show you guys two different ways to make your fabric strips, and for today I'm using the smallest size. And of course we need our fabrics, right? Also safety pins. I'm using safety pins in place of elastic threaders. For those of us who don't have elastic threaders, a safety pin works just fine. We need pins guys, lots and lots of pins. And the interfacing I am using is a fusible interfacing and it's very soft and cloth like. And of course we need pins. I'm going to use that with my bias maker, our ironing board, and also our iron. To prepare my strips, like I said earlier, I'm going to show you guys two different methods. So for the first method, you just take the wrong side of your fabric strip facing you and you fold the raw edges to the middle, both sides of the raw edges to the middle. This is the style I am more comfortable with. You take your iron and you iron till you get to the end of your fabric. This is the style I am more comfortable with. I am not really comfortable with the bias maker because I am not really used to it yet, but I am going to show you guys in case you want to use that style too. And some of the fabric may not really stay down immediately you fix it in, so you want to apply glue in the middle so it stays down. And now for the second style, I am going to be using my bias maker. So you want to cut your fabric 3 times bigger than the finished size of your bias. So if you want your fabric to end up as 1/2 inch, you want to cut your fabric to 1.5 inch so that when you slip it through your bias maker, it comes out when the edges fold to 1/2 inch. I hope you guys understand. So what I did, I cut off the edge to make a pointed edge, push the fabric as far as I can inside the bias maker, and used my needle to push it out. When it comes out to the other side, the edges are already folded. So what you have to do is just move your bias maker as you go, or as you iron. As you are moving it, the edges are getting folded, so you just iron as it comes out and stays. And also the bias maker has this handle. And also another way to make it fast is just by pulling it through like that underneath your iron, and it comes out and it stays. But like I said, I'm not really comfortable with this style. I prefer the first style, and that is the style that I use. Hope you guys understand. So something I do before I start picking all the strips together and start weaving them is that I arrange all of the strips according to the colors that I have, so I know what I'm working on. Okay, so I have the glowy side of the interfacing facing me. The side that has the glow is the side that is shiny and rough. That is the side that has the glow. And I'm going to show you guys two methods of weaving the fabric, of basket weaving. So you can start from any side, from the middle, and work your way to the right and the left. I am not really comfortable with that style, but I'm just showing you guys that anyway is possible. You can start vertically, you can start horizontally, whichever one you are more comfortable with. Okay, so the style I am more comfortable with is starting from the left hand side and working my way down to the right hand side. Okay, so starting from the edge, from one edge of my interfacing, and working my way to the other edge of the interfacing. So you just want to line your fabric strips, oh god, English, as close as possible to each other so the interfacing doesn't show. You want to make them almost overlap. Sometimes my strips almost overlap, but you want to make sure they are kissing each other as closely as possible. I am just showing you guys one method of making your basket weaving. So when you place your strip on your interfacing, you pin it at the top, you pin it at the bottom. That is one way of making the first strip or the first part of your basket weaving. If you don't understand anything, do not hesitate to leave me a comment in the comment section so that I can explain better, okay? I am done fixing the vertical part of my strips and it's time for me to fix in the horizontal part of the strips. But before I do that, I promise to show you guys two methods of basket weaving. So I'm going to show you guys one method right now. So for this method, I am going to unpick the bottom strips. I am going to remove the pins from the bottom strips. You only need the pins, or you only need to pin down the top strips for this method. Okay, so we are just going over and under, over and under. That is a basket weave. And for the strips that the fabric or the horizontal strips will be underneath it, I am going to flip it up. And for the strips that the vertical or horizontal strip will be on top of it, I am going to leave it down. I hope the video is self-explanatory enough. I am trying as much as possible to make you guys understand. So I am just fixing the vertical strip underneath and pinning it from one side to the other side, and I am going to bring back the strips that I flipped up. I hope you guys understand. So I am going to do this for like the very first four horizontal or vertical strip. I have even forgotten which is horizontal or vertical. For the first four horizontal strip, to make you guys understand better. So I'm trying to make you guys understand, for the very first strip, the vertical strip or the horizontal strip went on top. So now the second strip is going to go underneath. Okay, I hope you guys understand, and I hope the video is self-explanatory enough. So for the strips that we flipped up the first time, now they are going to be down. And for the ones that were down the first time, now we are going to flip them up. I hope you guys understand that. So that is that for the first method of basket weaving. I hope you guys understand. So guys, I am done pinning the bottom part of my strips. So this is the first one that we did. For this part, I am going to be using my elastic threader. I got this off AliExpress, but for the sake of those of us who may not have this, I use this in place of the weft needles. It is actually weft needles that we need, not this. But but this works really well. It works just fine. So for those of us who don't have that, I am going to be using this. This works well, like this is just, this does it well. Okay, this does it well. So I am just going to go ahead and pin this. So now we are going to use the pin to guide the fabric through our weaving. So we are just going over and under, over and under, over and under. This time around, we are not flipping any strip off, but we are using our pin to go over and under the strips. I hope you guys understand that. I also need you guys to know that your strips don't have to be as small as this. You can start off with bigger strips. I was going for a particular look, that was why I made my strips to be as small as this. And also you can use your hands if you are using bigger strip, like 1/2 inch or 1 inch, but for that I feel like you're going to get tired really fast. That won't really work effectively. So if you don't have elastic threaders or wefting needles, use safety pins. That is that for the safety pin, guys. So now I am going to use my elastic threaders. I am using two. One is going to guide the fabric through and one is going to pave way for the other one that is guiding the fabric through. I hope you guys understand. So over and under, over and under, over and under. As you can see, I am using the smaller one to lift up the fabric so that the bigger one can go under. I hope you guys understand. So that is how you use the elastic threaders or wefting needles if you have wefting needles. Okay, so that is that for the two methods. The first method, you have to flip your strips up. The second method, you don't have to flip anything up. You just have to get your fabric or your strips and guide them through the vertical strips. Okay, so guys, if there is anything you don't understand, feel free to ask me questions. Okay, so I am going to do this till I get to the end of the interfacing. So when I get to the end of the interfacing, I am going to come back and show you all the next step. So we have gotten to the end of our interfacing, and this is what we are looking like right now. It is time for us to make use of our iron. So at this point, you don't want to rub your iron on your weaving. You just want to place it in order for the gum to glue to the strips. And if you use a good interfacing, my interfacing is like a color stay, like a soft color stay. But you want to use like soft wording instead of soft color stay. I feel like soft wording is going to glue well. That's like woven interfacing, yeah? Woven interfacing. So I'm just removing the pins, carefully removing the pins from one side to the other and iron them down, okay? I hope the video is self-explanatory enough. If there is anything you don't understand, please ask questions, okay? So guys, now that I have flipped my strips to the wrong side, now we can easily rub our iron on the interfacing in order for it to glue very, very well. Okay, so now I am going to take my strips or my weaving to the sewing machine, because like I said earlier, the interfacing I used does not really glue well. So in order to hold it down better, I took it to the sewing machine and I sewed as close to the edge as possible. So what I am going to do now is that I am going to trim the excess strips. I am going to trim the excess strips so that we can have our weaving. Okay, I'm so excited for this part. Are we ready for the reveal, guys? isn't this just lovely, guys? Isn't this just lovely? Guys, when you try this out, please do share pictures with me. Use the hashtag DIYBJuliet on Instagram so that I can find you and I can post you. I want to see what you make. I want to see your own weaving, okay?